Hi and welcome to this tutorial. Here I will show you how to use the round function in Excel in order to round numbers that either do or don't have decimals. It's a pretty powerful function that's going to save you a lot of time in Excel. So if you'd like to get this workbook, go to teachexcel.com, search for the video tutorial, and you can download it there. So what I've got here, it's just a list of sample numbers with decimals. Nothing special. Use it for really anything that you need. There's no specific example here, just going to show you how to use the function and how it can work. So let's go ahead and start. I've got the function listed over here in nice big bold letters, so equals round. You've got the argument for number and number of digits. So let's start right here. We've got 13.806, and if you look in the formula bar, about a million decimals. Not really, but a lot. So let's round that down. So equals round, open parentheses, select the number I'd like to round, this cell right here, B2, comma. Now, what number of digits would I like to round? I'm going to show you the first one, or the most commonly used way to do it. And it's pretty much this. Whatever number you type here that's positive, that's how many digits after the decimal place are going to be kept intact. So if I would like it to round to two decimal places, I'm going to put 2 in here, close the parentheses, and hit enter. And then we get 13.810. And what I'm going to do here is actually expand the decimal place listing just so we can see. Just so we can see that it only takes in 13.81, right? So it rounded to the second decimal. The third one was a 6, so it rounded the second one up to an 8. It rounded the second one up to a 1. Now here we've got 1.42 and a bunch of other decimals, so let's try and round this to the nearest integer. The easiest way to do that, equals round, open parentheses, select the cell with a number in it, right here, comma, number of digits, well, 0. So you type 0 if you want it to simply go to the nearest integer. Close parentheses, and it gives us 1. Now for this one, I'm going to go back to decimals just so we can kind of get the hang of it. Let's take it to one decimal place. So equals, round, open parentheses, select this number, comma. Now number of digits. Instead of 2, let's do 1 this time. So let's round it to the first decimal place and see what happens. So we get 323.9. 0.9 does not change because 3 is closer to 0 than it is to 0.1, basically. So all the standard mathematical rounding rules apply here. Now here, let's round to an integer again, and this one should come out to be 240, and it does. That's because 0.6 is closer to 240 than 239. Now let's go, I'm going to make this one a little bit bigger, and show you what you can do to round on the left side of the decimal place. So we've got 2311.161 and a bunch of other decimals. But let's say that we just want to round to the nearest 100, right? So 2300 in this case. Well, what you do there is you put negative numbers in for the number of digits. So negative goes to the left side of the decimal. And the number of digits we'd like to go to the left is, in this case, 2. So negative 2, enter. And it gives us, rounded to the nearest 100, 2,300. Now I'm going to go ahead and change this one just so we can get the hang of that with another example. So this time, let's try and round it, this number right here, to the thousands. Well, to do it to the thousands, we do negative 3. 23,000. If you wanted to do it instead of the hundreds, do the tens, negative 1. 23,320, up from 318. So you see, what you may not have known is that you can use the round to round decimal places to the right of the decimal place, so, or the right of the decimal point, to round to the next highest or lowest integer, as in here and here, as well as to round integers, so to go to the left of the decimal place. And in all three of these cases, you use a positive number to round to the right of the decimal point, 0 to round to the nearest integer, and a negative number to round to the left of the decimal point. And I've got the original syntax for the formula right here. So if you'd like to get this worksheet, go to teachexcel.com, search for the video tutorial, and you can download it there. And otherwise, that's pretty much it for this tutorial.